Welcome back to another episode. Now, the last couple of videos I was working mainly on the other end of the boat. This video, it's gonna be different. It's time that I finally deal with this giant mess here. Over the months, I started collecting tools and materials over here. And I'm getting tired of climbing in and out and stepping over all of this. And I have a really weird ramp going on here. So it's time for some proper stairs, and that's gonna be the main part of this video. Alright, so after cleaning up for a while, I had to find out the dimensions for the steps. For that I used the two levels here, and once they were set up, I could measure the height of the total rise and the length of the total run. That gave me some numbers to play with, and after making a couple different templates, I settled on three big steps. With the help of the template, it was really easy to find out all the angles for the framing parts. And as so often, I try to keep the cost down, and I'm using an old Douglas fir board that I saved from a burn pile a while ago. And I actually managed to cut out all the framing parts from this one board, and I still had material left. Alright, now that pretty much wraps up all the framework. Now I have to paint some of the paneling, and don't ask me how I managed to trace the shape of those side panels. It might have involved a couple wasted pieces, but hey, I got it done, and they do fit like a glove. I'm using a couple chunks of hardboard here. This is not my favorite material to work with, but I had it kicking around, so why not using it? And I had to screw on a couple improvised clamps made out of scrap material to keep the top in place, and that worked pretty good. I cut up some 3/8 of an inch marine grade plywood for the treads, and I milled some trim from this old board here. The trim will help to straighten the plywood and it will give it a nicer looking edge as well. I just didn't film this, I don't want to wear down your patience by watching me for hours on a table saw. And the assembly was pretty straightforward. As you have seen, I cut a slot in the trim so the plywood fits perfectly in that, and then I just used some wood glue and a couple 18 gauge brad nails to hold it all together. For years now, I have this box kicking around. They are scrap pieces from when I cut the angled half-lap joints for the frames of the boat, and I just couldn't get myself to throw them out. I just knew one day I will find a way to use them. Well, that day is today. So the first step was to get them all equal in thickness and shape. And this is a really awkward shape, so it was kind of tricky to cut on a table saw, and I'm using a piece of scrap wood with some sandpaper glued to it to push it through the saw. Also, the boards I used for the framing of the boat were a little bit too wide originally, so I had this bundle of cutoff strips that I thought might be useful here too. I ran them through the planer as well, and then there was a ton of sanding involved to round over the edges. At this point, there was just one more thing left before I could start the creative part. I really wanted to be able to use the space underneath the steps, so I decided to use a long piano hinge to attach the treads. And now the fun part starts. Believe it or not, those have been 389 pieces, and it took me solid 3 days to cut them, sand them, and glue them in place. Now, you might have some questions about this here, so I'm going to try to be proactive here. You might wonder why having steps here at all, and where are they leading to? Now, my plan is to have a big door here that is hinged at the top, very similar to the carabout, just bigger. And I also plan on having some sort of a foldable platform between the two noses in the front here. How exactly I'm going to do that, I can tell because I don't know yet. All I know is I will figure it out at some point. And that will give me just a platform to sit on the outside, and the door would provide some sort of cover. And that's why I need some steps leading up to that. Now, I could have made them a little bit more narrow, but this is a space that it would have been really hard to utilize otherwise, so I might as well enjoy the comfort of those wide steps. They are also fairly deep, but with the help of those templates that I made, I realized that 3 steps that are fairly deep give me the most space on the inside, and I'm hoping to be able to fit some batteries in here in the future that would balance out a little bit the weight that I have in the back with the outboard motor, the fuel tank, and the water tanks. And that's the reason why I built those weirdly shaped spacers, just so the batteries can sit on level ground in there. Now, before I show you the final result, let me thank you for your interest. This project seems to turn into focus of this channel now, which is kind of ironic because I almost didn't upload anything about it. My wife encouraged me to show it to you guys. Anyways, it's gonna slow down the next couple months a little bit. We're heading into really cold weather. We're expecting minus 25 to minus 30 degrees Celsius during the day. And even though I have my homemade heater, it becomes more challenging to maintain an even heat, and I start getting trouble with all the glues and epoxies. They don't cure as well as they should. That won't mean there's no content at all. It just means there's not going to be a video every week. Besides that, my wife has 2 weeks off, so I would like to spend some time with her as well. All right, well, thanks for your patience, and here are the final shots.